Morning children, so let's revise this topic once again, our home and environment. So in that lesson, we in our previous video we discuss about different types of houses and why we required a house. House means it gives a shelter, it is also a resting place, it gives protection against the sun, wind, cold and the rain, protection from wild animals, keeping ourselves safe from the antisocial elements. Okay, so that is home provides security, control, belonging, identity and privacy also. And also we learn about the various types of houses that found in major regions and types of houses in India. So in various, that in the desert region, marshy region, mountain region, so various types of houses are found. So, but and one reason why people become homeless, it's a big problem why people become homeless. They have, it has a behind some reasons why the people became homeless, because of inadequate income, people being homeless, unemployment also one of the reason of being homeless, then physical and mental disorders, natural disasters, then poverty is a big problem in India, and lack of affordable housing. So these are the some reasons of being homeless. So we all have a right to clean, potable water, sufficient food, shelter and education also. So in our lesson we learn, then various material that required to prepare a house, that is brick, cement, iron, wood, water, rubble, glass, floor tiles and roof tiles and tin sheets. These are the available materials that are required for building a house. Also we learn, it's the population of the world is increasing all the time, and that's why houses are being built in a large number. So this causes the natural resources have to be used in very great quantities to build a house. They are obtained using the methods. These methods are harmful to the environment and lead to the pollution of air, water, soil and noise pollution also. Okay, so these are some reasons: digging up hills for quarrying, then extracting sand from seashores and river beds, extracting stone and earth from the ground, drawing out excessive amount of groundwater, then felling trees to clear land, so filling up the ponds, lakes, streams, rivers and low-lying areas to reclaim land because of growing urbanization. Land which was previously being used for agriculture and similar other purposes is now being used to build roads and raise settlements. Okay, it is because of only an increasing population. So when this leads to shortage of agricultural land, forest land is used for agriculture. Forest land is used means trees are felled in a great number and forests are reduced, and it gives a big impact on the environment. Okay, so energy is needed to produce construction material. Sab ite banane ke liye energy ki zarurat hoti hai, lohe ke tukde kaatne ke liye energy ki zarurat hoti hai. So that it is used on very large scale to prepare bricks from soil, cement from limestone, glass from sand and so on. So from where this energy come from? So it is produced using natural fuels like coal, natural gas, mineral oils, and these natural fuels can be used only once. And ek bar wo khatam ho gaye, khatam ho gaye. So they get consumed when we use them. Moreover, burning these fuels lead to air pollution. It takes lakhs of years for these sources of energy to form in nature. So that's why it is necessary to bring into use other sources of energy, such as eco-friendly sources of energy. that is renewable sources of energy, that is solar energy, wind energy, which are available in plenty and which do not cause any kind of pollution. So these are non-exhaustible sources of energy, that is renewable. All living things need shelter, like humans. Some other living thing also build shelters using various material in their environment. So we should also be able to make permanent houses that are eco-friendly. So we can control on the environmental pollution by making eco-friendly houses. Eco-friendly, some characteristics of eco-friendly houses are, so it has minimum consumption of natural resources, then use of non-exhaustible sources, of energy such as biogas, wind energy and solar energy. They are non-exhaustible sources. Recycling of water takes place here, then recycling of garbage also, then avoiding artificial materials and artificial colors, then provision for natural light and ventilation in the houses. These are the some characteristics of eco-friendly houses. So sometimes ask in exam this, write some characteristics of eco-friendly houses. Okay. Then next is the underwater shelters. You know this, water tourism has now become an important occupation. In some places, there are underwater shelters for tourists. From these shelters, we get a direct view of the seabed and the amazing marine life. So such shelters are observed in the coastal regions of Europe and North America. These are the water tourism, underwater shelters. Okay. So this is about the house and environment. So we learn from this lesson, we observe varieties of types of house construction in regions of that different climate. House are built to suit the climate of that region. Then different materials, all obtained from nature, are used to build houses. It is necessary to increase the use of non-exhaustible sources of energy. And it is necessary to build eco-friendly houses. We must take care of the environment is not harmed. So this objectives we learn from this lesson. Now let's move to the exercise. Question number A. Which of the following house would be suitable in the mountain region? So pictures are given, approximate box give reason for selecting that house. So right. First question is, so this is a picture, which number is correct? A, B, C, D, which figure, which house is suitable in the mountain region? So number, this house, number one, first one is suitable for mountain region. So this house is made up of natural material available in the mountains. Okay. So that is a stone. It is strong to withstand mountainous wind. Then question B, what materials will you mainly use for building a multi-storied house? Choose the correct option. The options are given. One is mortar, coal, cement, bricks. Number B, cement, bricks, cotton, iron. Then number C, iron, cement, mortar, bricks. So answer is C, iron, cement, mortar, bricks. Okay, in option B, cotton is not useful, and in A, coal is not useful. So option C, that is iron, cement, mortar and bricks, that are useful for building a multi-storied house. Okay, then next question is, arrange the following considerations from the most of to least important in house building. So most to least important in house building. So options are given: A, luxury; B, structure; C, climate. First we consider a climate, then structure, and then luxury. Okay, then next question 3, write the following. First one is, list the eco-friendly things in your house. List eco-friendly things in your house. So you have to write down this answer on your own. So which eco-friendly things, which useful thing you use in your house. So it's a personal response question. So write down. कौन सी इको-फ्रेंडली या नेचुरल थिंग्स है आपके घर में, आप लिख सकते हो. देन नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन बी, विच ऑफ द गैजेट इन द हाउस कैन बी रन ऑन सोलर एनर्जी. सो दैट इज द आंसर इज कैलकुलेटर, सोलर कुकर, यू हैव अ सोलर लाइट, यू कैन राइट. ओके, सो दिस इज द आंसर. देन क्वेश्चन 4, what are the types of pollution that can be observed at a construction site? Usually the type of pollution that are seen at a construction site, that are air pollution, water pollution, soil pollution and noise pollution also. Okay, all the 4 types of pollution occurs on the construction site. Okay, so this is the question. Then one activity you have to do, it prepare a model of an eco-friendly house. So you have to prepare it, and then some few more question answers we solve this. So write down this question, so this activity, this chart. The chart is given on the page number 54. Let's solve this chart. You have to write down material given and its original source we have to write down. Okay, so please note down in your copy. So bricks made up of soil. Soil is its original source. Then cement, we get cement from limestone. Okay, then iron, that is from iron ore we obtain. Then wood from trees we get. Then water from rain. Then rubble from soil. Then glass from sand. Then floor tiles, clay and fine sand. Then sand, we get sand from river. Roof tiles from soil. And tin sheets from tin ore. So this is original source and its material. Okay, then few more question answers. So the next question is, name the following. So please, government provides shelter for homeless in cities, that is night shelters. Okay, then source from which cement is made, that is limestone. Answer is limestone. Then natural fuels, write down some natural fuels, that is coal, natural gas, mineral oil. Then pollution caused by burning fuel, that is air pollution. Then very important, non-exhaustible sources of energy, that is solar energy, wind energy and biogas. Then two continents having water tourism. Write down, you can write Europe and North America. So this is about the name the following, sometimes asked in exam. So next video we will continue with new topic of revision. Okay, so bye everyone.